I'm Mallory, a practitioner of classical Chinese medicine, and in this video, I am joined by my friend, wellness coach, and intuitive, Rita Abdallah, and we are going to be sharing with you a bit about fall and the autumn season and what that means, not only from a Chinese medicine perspective, but also an energetic medicine and spiritual perspective as well.
Great. And so I'm super excited that we are joining forces on Sunday, September 29th from 1 to 3 p.m. And remind me, what's the address that we're meeting at?
We'll be in Lakewood, Ohio, and it's 18615 Detroit Avenue, upstairs.
Okay. So Sunday, September 29th, please join us. We are looking forward to not only offering some guidance on how to welcome the fall season, but really having some techniques and exercises to enjoy, really, and really step into the moment of fall, so that we're not looking back at summer and wishing it was here and not dreading the fact that winter is up ahead, that we're really in the moment with fall, in the spirit of fall.
Yeah, there is a link below in the box to register for the class. And as you talk about not or letting go of summer, that is one of the biggest themes in classical Chinese medicine that has to do with the autumn season. It's all about letting go, as well as being able to receive. So the two organs that are associated with the fall season are the lungs and the large intestine. So as you can imagine, when we breathe and take in oxygen, we receive that energy and then we also let it go. And so the same with the large intestine, with the bowels, we receive food and nurture and nutrition and then we let it go as well. I know, Rita, for you, from an energetic standpoint, the idea of receiving and letting go means maybe something a little different to you. Can you expand on that?
Absolutely. So around this time of year, I end up seeing clients who are motivated to purging, and not just their house or their car, but a memory or something that is creating some kind of heaviness, and they want to kind of let that dissolve. And turn into something else that's more meaningful and useful to them. And so you may even actually, as I'm thinking about it, you may be having conversations with people, I gotta clear that garage, or that one closet, or that one room in the house really needs there's just stuff in there that needs to let go, because I'm getting tired of looking at it, or it's creating a feeling of suffocation, right? Which is what Mallory's alluding to when we're wanting to get stuff out of the lungs. There could be also, from a very personal perspective, when I'm talking personal, like the mental and the emotional or the spiritual sides of us, where there's something that we've been holding on to, and there's some energy that's keeping us strong enough and ready, that we're willing to push that forward. Summer is a season of high activity and a lot of energy and being outside and just wanting to get, you know, as much as we can out of summer. But there's also this piece that now fall just gently moves us in. And so we get to go a little bit more inside of ourselves. And again, we have enough fire from the summer to allow that motion to happen. And I think fall also, air is a powerful part of fall, and air that we draw in through breath and release out, so that the inner self gets to expand in all directions, you know, not just the lungs and the intestine, but all of us gets to feel that expansion.
Mm-hmm. And I'm curious, when you talk to your clients about letting go, but then also, what do you do when you do let go? Because it's so common in our society to want to then fill that space, that emptiness that we see, again, whether it's physical or within ourselves, with something else. So what do you do with that? How would you respond to that question?
Oh, that's a really great question, Valerie. I love that one. So, you know, what we're letting go of our experiences or attachments that keep us charged, and charged from the perspective of creating anxiety or sadness or something that, you know, again, creates heaviness. And so when we're ready to detach or release or shed those particular energies, we feel fueled. So on the other side of something that charges us in a way that's not so great is this fuel that allows peace, love, and joy to enter our spaces, and that we're more empowered, that we're more, that the parts of us get to stretch. So we're not taking in more sadness and more anxiety, that we're actually giving peace a chance. We're allowing light and air to move us in ways that keep us energized and alive, really alive.
Yeah, and just filling the body with more chi. That chi doesn't necessarily have to be attached to or associated with anything other than joy, clean air, vitality. Just keep it simple and keep it general. In Chinese medicine, they associate an emotion with each season. And the emotion that's associated with the autumn season and fall is going to be sadness and grief. And so, as Rita was articulating before, we now have the warmth of the summer to lead us into a cooler time. So we still have that charge, but it also allows us to move inward and literally sometimes cave and want to hold our chest, which can encourage the grieving process or maybe make us feel a little bit more comfortable with the grieving process and the sadness. So when a patient or a client comes to you and they are very sad, filled with a lot of sadness, grief, depression, and it's weighing down on them. And what happens in Chinese medicine is when we feel that sadness, we feel the heaviness in our chest and the qi actually sinks. Our lungs, if you've seen them physically, are quite a masterpiece. So there's a lot of places for things to go and get stuck. And they have so much depth to them. There's one way in and one way out through the same pathways. So again, coming back to the question, when somebody comes to you and they're filled with that sort of pressure and grief, how would you begin to help them to surrender? Lot of being able to let go is that ability to surrender as well.
Absolutely. So in my practice, I use a combination of aromatherapy with sound and energy work. We do some talking, but we want the energy really to show up so we can see it, right? We want to see what form it's taking. It has taken, whether it's sadness or grief or something else, or loneliness, right? I think loneliness is connected to those other pieces there. And so, again, with some motivation, again, we can use the season as our platform here, that when we allow space, we're holding space for somebody to allow that surrender to happen. So the energy can shift now. And the client or patient is willing to move it. And so reminding that anybody, right? So when they're in this motivating time of wanting to change and get out of this form called sadness, grief, loneliness, that the other side is where we're heading.
And so transformation.
Yeah, the other side. And the other side, I believe, of grief and sadness and loneliness is freedom, is compassion, and is not just a surrender, but maybe acceptance. Yeah. So we're filling ourselves up. That's the fuel. We're filling ourselves up with that fuel, and that's what's on the other side. There's no way that we go through these experiences and not feel like we're heading somewhere. So I think you and I are quite passionate about helping people move forward, whether it's through energy or acupuncture or Chinese medicine or herbs or whatever that might be, that what's on the other side is what gets us excited to show people that, and that there is a path forward.
Yeah, make sure to check out Rita's Instagram. It's Grateful
Rita.
Dot Rita.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, something like that.
She's got a nice series going right now. It's entitled Spirit of Fall. This is Mimi. This is Rita's little one. And she talks a lot about what we're having a conversation about in each of her posts. And one thing that she mentioned here is not only is it the season of grief and letting go, but also the season of compassion.
Mm-hmm.
Can you expand on that as how you relate to the fall season and compassion?
Yeah. So if those energies, as we're talking about, like the overall themes of grief and sadness and loneliness enter our spaces, I've been seeing clients lately, and the theme for sure is loneliness these days.
Mm-hmm.
And so this idea of not, you know, when we think about compassion, it's almost as if people are drawn to a definition of where you are more loving and open and less judgmental towards another person. But I think the fall also allows us to extend that same idea of being understanding to ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
So this idea of self-compassion, that you are bigger than loneliness, that your fuel is compassion. And we're going to get you to feel that way about yourself to the degree that you're willing to do that and go
mm-hmm.
there. And so if you have a season or a reason that really gets you there, then it's time. It's time
mm-hmm.
to move that way.
Yep. We yeah. are guided to live with nature and to live within it, which is why Chinese medicine has these associations for each season, because it is a medicine that relies on the season to guide the human.
And really about taking somebody, again, to the other side, where growth and wisdom and healing and this this inner knowing and belief that we are able to do something
mm-hmm. to plant the seeds for spring.
Yeah, and we're not stuck.
Right,
we're not stuck.
Right,
we're always moving forward.
Absolutely. Well, Rita, thank you for joining me.
Yeah.
And again, there's a link to register for the class. We'll have information on Chinese medicine overall about the fall season, of course, as well as dietary therapy from the Chinese medicine perspective. And then Rita's going to lead us through some energy work, some breath work, some visualization, and
aromatherapy.
Some aromatherapy as well. So working with essential oils.
Mm-hmm. So we're super excited to work together and to bring this wisdom to you and really create a beautiful day. I'm looking forward to it.
Awesome. Me
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
Thanks again, and I will see you next week.
Thank you.